Let's learn a little more on 2D precision. What's up, and welcome to Maker Tales, where I'm sharing my maker journey to help you go further in yours. So don't forget to subscribe and hit that little bell icon to never miss an opportunity to keep making. This video is all about carrying on learning 2D precision and the pitfalls that are in it before we go ahead and jump into 3D precision. Starting once again with a fresh Blender file, let's carry on our mastery of 2D precision. So let's go ahead, let's select everything, delete it, and create ourselves that single vertex once again as our starting point. Then I'm going to go into our top view, zoom in a bit, and what I'm wanting to do is create a 2mm by 2mm square. Now I'm going to show you something interesting here. So let's go 2 on the Y, hit enter, and now this really doesn't have to do with precision modeling, but it's something interesting to know anyway. When you have one vertex selected in edit mode, if you hold down control and then you right click, you're going to get this sort of organic pathway creation of extrusion that you can do really quickly. Just something that I wanted to slip in there. Right, now let's go into our edge selection, select this edge, extrude it out by 2mm and hit enter. Right, so we have this here. We're not really wanting to deal with faces just yet, so let's go ahead, let's go face selection and delete only faces. So we're left with our vertices and edges here. So first, let's cover bevels and chamfers, because within precision modeling, we absolutely love them. However, I'm sorry to say they're not quite as parametric and easygoing in Blender, but I will show you a way of the most parametric way there is, but that's more in the 3D space. But right this minute, I want to show you the destructive method as well as how to fix the destructive method. So let's select a vertex and let's go ahead and use the shortcut for beveling, which is going to be Control B. Over here is the button, but let's use Control B and you'll see nothing is happening. Now, I want to draw your attention down to the bottom tooltip bar. You are going to see there's a whole bunch of shortcuts here. For right now, there's only one really to know, which is V. This is to affect vertices, because right this minute, without a face, it doesn't know what a real edge is here. So now, as you pull this, you'll see you'll get a chamfer, and if you want to turn this into a bevel, you can use the scroll wheel to add segments to it. Now, we could also put in a number here, so let's go with 0.35. Let's hit enter, and that's it done. You'll also see that on the bottom left, once we've done our confirming, we have the dialog box. And here you have it, 0.35, we've got our segments and all this. I'm going to change this now to 0.5. I'm going to go for 10 segments and I'll leave it at that. There's a lot more to cover here, which I basically want you to go and explore. You'll see that this is what we did with our shortcut of V. We went from here to there, and there's even the ability to create your own custom ones, but I'm not going to cover this right here. Right, let's go ahead here and let's create a chamfer, Control B, V, let's put down our segments down to almost nothing, and then let's go again with 0.5, hit enter, and I'm happy with that. So let's go about and reconstruct this destructive method, because we've just added a whole bunch of vertices. How do I go back to just the square that we had? Well, the easiest way that I found is going into active element, select everything, create one of these as the active element, and then from here, we're gonna scale in the direction that we want all these other points to go in. So I'm gonna scale in the Y direction, and you'll see as I go up to 0, and you can see the number is right here. As I go closer to 0, it pulls it up. So let's just type in 0. And that's it done. Now we can select all these extra vertices that we don't need. So let's go with those there. Let's hit X and let's dissolve vertices. Now there is one extra vertex there that I didn't get. Let's dissolve that one too. And now let's go ahead and do it here. I'll do it in the X this time. So I'm going to turn this one into our active vertex, let's go scale on the X and let's hit 0. Great, now I can go ahead and select this vertex here and dissolve it. With those covered, let's go ahead and let's take a look at offsets. Now, this is something that we use quite a bit within precision modeling, so I want to show you how we can do it here in Blender. So with this selected, we have a lovely add-on called Mesh Edit Mesh Tools or something like that. So if we go over to edge, you will have offset edge, offset, and that's it right there. We have this dialog box right here where we can set our offset amount. Let's go with 0.0, oh, that's a bit small actually, 0.3. And let's hit enter, and that is now an offset of 0.3 all the way around this edge. If we wanted, we could have gone the other direction and gone with minus 0.3, and we've gone inwards. So that's offsets done. Okay, it's now time to go ahead and explore some faces. So let's delete this, what we've just created here, and let's make a face. So we know that if we select everything, hit F, we've got a face. Let's undo that quickly, and I want to put a hole in that face. So let's go ahead and let's put the 3D cursor in the center of this. Do you remember how to do that? Well, with everything already selected, we're just going to go Shift S for our snapping menu and go cursor to selected, and that's going to put it in the center of our selection. So with that there, let's go Shift A, let's create a circle. Let's make this circle of a radius 0.5. That seems good to me. And now you would expect that all you have to do is select everything and hit F. I'm sorry to say that just sort of creates a mess within Blender. And the main reason why is because Blender needs to know where the faces are to this hole. So there's a quick way and a slow way of doing this. I'm first going to show you the slow way because this is the precision way, and then I will show you the quick way when precision doesn't matter. And I'll also show you why we would go about doing the slow way. So you're going to select a vertex here and a select a vertex over there, and then we're going to fuse those. Select these two here and we're going to fuse those as well. Then I'm going to use my circle selection and I'm going to select all the vertices or edges that are related to one of the faces. So all of those there, then I'll hit F, and then I'm going to select the rest of the edge loop here. So with all those selected, I can now hit F once again, and we have a face with a circle in it. Fantastic. Okay, so why on earth would I do that? Well, first of all, let's go ahead and make sure that we can see these edges nice and clearly, because I've obviously made them just a little bit too light. So let's go over into Edit, Preferences, and then we're going to go into Themes, 3D View, and then on this Edit Wire, I'm just going to make it just a touch darker so that it's easier for you to see it. You might not need to, but just so that you can see it nice and clearly here. So there we have it. We've done that, and now what's the quicker way of doing it, and why did I do it this way? Well, remember, we have CAD transforms, and when we turn on CAD transforms, we can use edge centers as a snapping. So if we hold down G now, you can see we could snap to any edges that we make on a surface. So just be aware that edges can be very useful if you're needing snapping points. But if you're not needing a snapping point and you're just wanting to quickly put in a hole somewhere, this is how to do it on a surface. Let's undo this that we've created here. And the quickest way to go about it is just going ahead and selecting everything and going Alt F. And there we have it. You're going to see that it creates a whole bunch of geometry here. Now, I'm not here to talk about what's the right geometry. If you're an animator or a modeler or a video game designer, we know that you need either triangles, quads, or some lovely perfect geometry here. We're talking about precision here, so we're wanting to keep this as clean and as minimal as possible. So what we're going to do is just select everything, hit X, and we're going to go with Limited Dissolve. And with Limited Dissolve, you'll see that it removes almost absolutely everything that we don't need. And there you have it. That's how you go ahead and plop a hole very quickly. So let's go ahead and add another hole over here, for instance. All right, so if I go Shift, right click, we've got our 3D cursor over there. Let's go Shift A, let's add a circle. Let's make this circle nice and small so that it fits there. Great. And now we know that we have two ways of going about making this hole, because that's not going to make a hole just like that. We need to go ahead and tell it where its faces are that make this hole. And like I said, it needs a minimum of two faces. So it could go ahead, cut across here and join there if you're wanting some precision edges, or we can just go back into face selection, select everything, delete only faces. Then let's go ahead and let's just delete these extra edges because we don't really need them for this Right now, let's select everything, go Alt F, then let's X, limited dissolve, and this can be as low as 0.1, by the way, it doesn't need to be so high. And there we have it. Now, of course, this is going to give you some strange results sometimes that you're not wanting. So take that with a pinch of salt. We have this quick way, but we also have the slow way when it comes to absolute precision that you're wanting. Now, I want to go back to the last video where I talked about auto merge and how I was going to show you auto merge once we got into faces. Okay, well, let's go ahead and do that right now. So if we go to our tools and we have our options here, you have auto merge as we've already talked about, but we also have this other option, which is split edge faces. What exactly does this do? Well, if we turn on auto merge and turn this on, if we go into our vertex selection, hit this vertex here, and we extrude this out. Keep in mind that we are in the top view, so this is very much a planar extrusion because it's not going to go up and down on the X. When we left click now, you're going to see what happens. It has automatically split this edge and this face. So if we go into face selection, you can see that we now have two faces here. Now there's a little caveat to this though. If I undo this here and we were in the 3D space and we go ahead and do this extrusion outwards, and then we use my favorite add-on, which is CAD transforms. So let's go Alt-C, let's go space. Oops, sorry, I forgot to hit G first. Got to make sure you're in an operation before you change the shortcuts. So hit G, then you can go space. Then we're going to go V for vertex. So all I've done is change from edge centers to vertex. Let's select this vertex. Let's hit space once again, and let's go Shift-E for edge centers. You would expect that if I click this here to that edge center, that it would automatically split that face. Well, I'm sorry to say that CAD Transforms does not have that functionality just yet. You will see that it is very much one face here, and the edge is still here, very much on its own. So if I go here and I hit G and I move this up, that's not being connected. So just be aware of that. If you're using CAD Transforms, it's not going to be able to do this split edge faces. However, with that already there, what we could go ahead and do and just go G on the X direction and, sorry, on the Y direction, let's go 0.1 and then we hit enter. That has just split it and we already know the distance that it's moved out of the way. So we can go back to G, Y, minus 0.1. And there we have it. Now it has split it because we were using default Blender movement. So there is a little caveat that I wanted to show you. This can be useful for those that are working with a whole bunch of faces and need to split a face very precisely like that. But just be aware that that is how auto merge works and how split faces work as well. So from what I'm aware, the author of CAD Transforms is going to try and implement this, but it's not his top priority currently. So let's go ahead and let's go and sort of create ourselves a problem to solve here. So I'm just going to very quickly just sort of clean up that what we've got here. So I'm just going to grab all the faces here. I'm going to delete only faces, delete the edges that I don't really want here. So all of these here. Let's go ahead, X, let's go edges, let's select everything once again, let's do our Alt F, our X, and then let's do our limited dissolve. Right, so we have this outcome once again. So now let's make a mess. Let's go one, let's grab this vertex, and let's give it a great big chamfer. So Control B, V, and now let's pull this all the way there and right, things are a real mess right this minute. It's things like this that if you don't really know how to deal with it in a 2D space, it can really throw you off in a 3D space. So let's go ahead and clean this up. So what I think is the easiest way of doing it is let's go ahead and remove the things that make it harder to see what's really going on. And for me, that's faces. So let's go three, delete all the faces that are around a problem. Let's go ahead, hit X, and let's go Limited, no, only faces. Only faces. Alright, already that looks so much cleaner to work with. So, I'm sure you're seeing where I'm going with here. So let's go see. What we're wanting to do is sort of cut out this area because the chamfer's gone all the way up into the hole. So let's go ahead and clean that. So let's go edge selection, let's go circle selection, and select all the edges that are not going to be part of this anymore. So those obviously not going to be a part anymore. So let's go X and remove those edges. Now right here though, these are intersecting. Do you remember the great add-on that's used for intersecting? We have our right click and we have our tiny CAD. And let's go right here, intersect selected edges. And now we will go into our vertex selection to just double check that, yep, those intersections have now been created. Let's go into our edge selection, select these edges right here. Let's go ahead, hit X and hit edges. Now, we think that everything has been done correctly here. However, let's go ahead and let's see what happens. Let's delete these edges once again because I like cleaning edges. We could have just selected everything and hit RF, but let's go ahead, let's clean it all up. Let's select everything. Let's go Alt F, and what on earth is going on? Why has it filled that up? This should have gone completely differently. Well, let's go and investigate what's really happening here. If we go into our edge selection as we are right this minute, and we do an edge loop select, remember that is holding down Alt and doing a left click on an edge or a double left click, that will select the whole edge loop. Now, this is strange. Why is it not selecting all the edges all the way around? It should select it all. Well, obviously what's happening right here is these are not connected. And you could see that as well if we went into our box selection right this minute. So if we go with our W, oops, we were already in box selection. And now we turn on our X-ray, go into vertex selection, and let's select these right here. And you can see that we have two vertices. So obviously there's something not right here. So let's do the quickest fix here. Select everything, go M, and we're going to go merge by distance. At this point, you can see that four vertices were removed, and now we can go with our Alt F, our X, and our limited dissolve. And that there is it. You have just done your first mesh cleanup, and believe it or not, a whole bunch of Blender is mesh cleanup, especially when you're getting meshes from other sources. Well done for getting through this second 2D precision video. Yes, there's so much and it just keeps growing on it, but you're going to be so surprised how much of all of this 2D information relays perfectly into 3D. Stick to the end for a little something extra. A huge thank you to my patrons. You guys are absolutely awesome and it's the reason why I'm making these videos. And if you're enjoying what I'm making here and you think I'm worthy of your support, I would love to see you there too. Don't forget that we have a Discord linked down in the description. Thank you for watching, keep making, and let the quest continue. For the bold of you, there is this short little obstacle course to make sure you understand all the concepts that we've covered in this video. Along with that, there is a solution video in case you get stuck.